Hello and welcome to Bob Johnson's Computer Stuff Inc. We are the Panasonic Toughbook experts. I'm Solomon. Are you looking for a new Panasonic rugged tablet for work? Well, before making your purchase, you might want to hear this. It is important to shop backwards, meaning what will you need included with your tablet? This can be difficult if this is your first time shopping for a rugged tablet. Panasonic has so many different versions of the rugged tablet or ToughPad, it can be really hard to decide which one is best. Here are some quick tips to narrow down your search. These tips can help you in shopping for the ideal rugged tablet. Tip number one, learn more about durability. Each ToughBook has experienced its own level of halt or the highly accelerated life tests, but some are still more rugged than others. For example, the ToughBook CF19 is IP65 certified. This means it is a fully rugged computer. Tip number two, where will you be working? As a mobile worker, you may encounter all types of situations. Though they are extremely rugged, these laptops do have their limits. Knowing your labor conditions can protect your investment and save you money in the long run. Tip number three, choose the right OS. Choosing the wrong OS could mean disaster. For example, choosing a rugged tablet with Windows 8 could cause some issues. Windows 8 has had some major problems in the past, but Windows 8 has a hybrid mode which allows it to boot faster than a Windows 7 computer. But Windows 7 has been tried and tested to support most software. Tablets like the CF19 and H2 have been pre-installed with Windows 7 software. Windows 7 is one of the best operating systems for enterprise applications. Tip number four, double check your ports before purchase. This is a common mistake people make. For example, having a barcode scanner and GPS on the same tablet is extremely rare. Make a decision on which component is most important for you. Never assume something will be included. Do your research and make sure. Most tablets lag behind laptops in this area. The best way to solve this is to purchase a 2-in-1. The CF19 comes standard with a serial port. On the other hand, the H2 has a bus connector, so please know the difference. Well, that concludes our how-to video for today. If you have any questions, please feel free to comment. Also, don't forget to subscribe by clicking the link located here. Thank you for tuning in. Until next time.
Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel.